The B-2 is dreaded by all Americans' rivals for one main reason. It carries nuclear weapons. The stealth bomber is deadly and troublesome to track. The B-2 Spirit stealth bomber has swept wings measuring 52 meters across, half the length of a football field. Its cockpit bulges naturally from the surface, like that of a 1950s-era sci-fi spaceship. One critical aspect of the B-2's low observability is radar-absorbent materials. The B-2's skin is already majorly made up of non-conductive carbon graphite composite combined with titanium. Like the intakes, flaps, and leading edges of the wings, the most reflective areas are sprayed with other radar-absorbent material coatings, which have been repeatedly tweaked over the years. Furthermore, the skin is coated with an elastic, rubber-like polymer meant to smooth away seams, screws, or joints between different materials, creating a chink in its stealthy geometry. Although, these features reduce the B-2's radar cross-section to roughly 0.1 to 0.05 meters squared. Though most evident from the front, the B-2 is designed to remain low observable from all angles intended to penetrate deep into enemy airspace. Spirits are camouflaged for daytime and night strikes with non-reflective dark gray paint created to blend in with the sky at any distance of 23 miles or greater. The B-2 also sports unique bays intended to release a chemical to obscure contrails, but these were never used operationally. Alternatively, the Spirit has a LiDAR sensor to detect contrails, giving the pilot a possibility to change altitude to eliminate them. The Spirit is designed to fly across worldwide while carrying 20 to 30 tons of weapons, but not to do exceptionally quickly. Its turbofans lack afterburners, which in any case would cause infrared and even radar signatures to bloom. The Spirit's greatest speed is 630 miles per hour, so it's a bit faster than a jumbo jet, while its range of 5 to 7,000 miles is typically multiplied by 2 to 4 aerial refuelings, using a pop-up hatch behind the cockpit. This lets B-2s fly non-stop missions, lasting nearly 2 days from Whiteman in Missouri to hit targets across the globe. When B-2 approaches defended airspace, it enters stealth mode, retracting antennas, cutting off specific communication links, and even limiting the use of its flaps. If endangered by long-range radars and missiles over a wide area, it may descend to a low altitude to reduce detection range. Its terrain-following system allows the colossal bomber to skim as low as 200 feet above the ground. For its nuclear strike mission, which is still crucial today, the B-2 can carry up to 16 B-61 or megaton-yield B-83 nuclear gravity bombs on the rotary launchers within its two bomb bays. A Spirit's avionics are compressed versus the electromagnetic pulses created by nuclear blasts, and the pilots wear creepy white face masks to shield their eyes from the flash of detonation. The B-2 can also carry long-range AGM-154 JSOW glide bombs and AGM-158 JASSM stealth cruise missiles to deliver standoff attacks without risking getting too close to increasingly powerful modern air defense radars. Most amazingly, the B-2 is uniquely configured to deploy up to 2 bulky 30,000-pound GPU-57 massive ordnance penetrators designed to blast apart command bunkers up to 61 meters underground. This capability is meant to threaten the decapitation of hostile foreign leaders and destroy subterranean weapons facilities. The B-2's ability to deliver such devastating weapons deep within the most well-defended airspace makes it a premium, highly specialized war machine without equivalent, at least until China develops a decent H-20 stealth bomber. So far, B-2s have primarily leveraged their range and payload rather than stealth for actual combat operations. Hopefully, the Spirit's awesome firepower and low observable characteristics will never be tested in the kinds of high-intensity and likely nuclear great power conflict it was designed to fight.